We're here in Chagrin Falls, Ohio, and it's so cute and charming. There's so many great little shops and restaurants and
sweet little park behind us, popcorn shop over there, and it's home of industry insider
Gary Chick, who started Naturepedic. We're so excited to go meet him, learn about his mattresses, and to see how these organic mattresses are made.
We're gonna go find him right now. Let's go.
All right.
I'm Carter.
Hi, Carter and Heidi.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, Amy. Welcome to Naturepedic.
Thank you.
We're going to have you come in. You're going to meet Barry, the founder of our company, and get a big factory tour today.
Great. Cool. Love it.
Great. Come on in.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you very much for coming.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah.
We appreciate it.
Happy to work with you and
it's good to be here.
Help Emma and work for the common cause of reducing the use of toxic chemicals in our consumer products and just helping our entire society.
Well, we have a ton of questions for you.
Right.
We know a little bit, we think about mattresses, but probably not enough. How'd you get started?
Here's the true story. 11 years ago, when our first grandchild was on the way, I walked into a baby store to buy a crib mattress, and all the mattresses were made with vinyl, polyurethane foam. They contained phthalates. They contained flame retardant chemicals, some of which are very toxic.
Sure.
Some of the mattresses contained antimony in the surface fabrics. Some of them had pesticides, and so on. I talked to the salesperson, and I said, "What else do you have?" Salesperson says, "What's your problem?" "If it wasn't safe, the government wouldn't allow it to be sold."
Uh-huh.
I go, "Really?"
You knew better.
It hit me very hard that day. I came home and I told my wife, "You know, I don't know what to do. My grandfather slept on straw. Maybe we need to go to our Amish friends that don't live far away and just get some straw. Because what we have here is not progress." So that's how this whole thing started.
So then you just decided to start making mattresses and start making them more eco-friendly.
Correct.
What would be the difference between an organic mattress and a traditional mattress as far as the making of?
It starts with the general idea we don't want chemicals. The best material that you can use, organic fiber like an organic cotton, for example, is not grown with pesticides, you know, or other chemicals, or synthetic fertilizer.
So there's so many titles that you see mattresses on. For laymen, what are we supposed to look for? Because I feel like there's probably a lot of greenwashing going on.
When you're selling an organic tomato, or organic cherry, you cannot, by law, call it organic unless it went through the certification program.
Right.
Okay.
But beyond agricultural products, there is no law.
So a lot of people are just claiming green and eco-friendly?
Exactly.
And they're not?
They're claiming that the product is an organic product. Wow. When in fact, you can claim what you want.
That's amazing. So there's a ton of manufacturers that are out there.
Right. This is an organic pen.
Right. They're not.
You know, give me a break. You sleep 7-8 hours a day. It's about a third of your life. The rest of the day, you're working real hard to stay healthy. Right? You eat well, you work out, okay? How about the third of your life that begins in the evening?
Yeah,
all right.
When you hit age 75, you will have slept on a mattress for 25 years. What are you sleeping on?
What
are you sleeping on for 25 years?
Yeah, it's pretty crazy that people don't think about that.
Nobody thinks about it. Nobody pays attention.
You can be sleeping on 200 pounds of chemicals. Or you can be sleeping on 200 pounds of much better material.
Wow.
This is it. There's so many of them.
I know. Which one should we?
Okay. Well, you try this one.
No. Yeah.
Oh, that's
that
nice.
Feels good.
Yeah, that's really cushy.
Try them, and then try the other side, and you'll see the difference. One will be a little bit plusher, and one will be a little bit firmer. Sides. Five boxes, and just walk out the door into your car with five boxes, driving home.
That'd be awesome.
Can we do that?
You sure?
That'd be so cool. That'd be really cool.
These are my coils, all
you
right?
You sure you like that better? Not this one?
Yeah.
You haven't tried this one again.